how I pick charcoal, it just with my nose. Because, you know, it's about the aroma, it's about the smell, it's about, you know, the how you when you shave, the aroma that is releasing. It's very unique. If you really want to push a little bit over, probably is a kind of a garlicky smell and aroma. But, for example, I'm not really a big fan of garlic, right. But I love truffle. So I don't even know how the combination comes out. But, you know, people that maybe are smelling this for the first time say, oh, I smell like garlic, right? So that is probably something close. But definitely you can also smell earth. Mm. You can smell many times the chestnut. Truffle hunters are going out during the night with their dogs, right? Early in the morning, they are in one of our facility. We have different around Italy and Europe in general, also for black truffles. Early in the morning, the product is in one of our facility. We have a team of people that are cleaning the truffle. And let's say that by early afternoon, the product is ready to be shipped. Okay, it's packed, refrigerated, goes to the airport early, late night, the product gets here. We receive like the same night, usually, or early in the morning. And then as soon as we receive, we deliver to the restaurants. Or if we receive the night before, we ship to different carriers around the country. So let's say that by 10:30, the day after, they receive. As I said, in 36 hours, we go from underground to the tables. You go to eat to a restaurant, most likely the product is always fresh, probably no more than 48 hours. So first of all, you have to make sure that it's firm, that it's not soft and it's not spongy. Then the truffle has a cycle, right? It starts, it ripes, and then it goes back. Mm-hmm. Think about a fruit, think about like a banana, right? For example, that is maybe green and then start to ripe and then start to get little brown, the darker, and then all goes better.
Right.
So what happened is that when you get the peak, that truffle smells a lot, like fruit, right? As soon as it gets like, you know, the day before it goes bad, it's really smelling and releasing a lot of the aroma. So you start to smell off, as well, it smells off, or it's like you smell ammonia a little bit, that when like, okay, it's charcoal is a bad sign and it's better than you.
At a restaurant, how many grams should that
be? I have to say the average, you can stay between 3 and 5 grams.
Okay.
It's also based on the portion, like if it's an appetizer size, maybe even 1.5 to 2 grams. If it's a main course, probably you can really stay between 3 and 5.
When I've been over in Piemonte, I love having the truffles just very simply over, is it a tagine with butter. You are the expert. What are your favorite things to have truffle?
If you eat home, I always suggest to stay simple, okay? Don't mess the dish up with garlic, onion, stuff that can really cover, otherwise you don't enjoy. Simple, what I'm saying is, even a egg, you fry an egg, sunny side up, you shave a little bit and you put salt on top of the truffle too. That is the warmth is coming from the yolk. It's definitely releasing the aroma even more. So that is really enough to enjoy. If you really are not able to cook, that is the best. The tagliarin, as you said, definitely is great. Pasta, very simple, homemade. Egg pasta, that is really, again, the egg, the protein that are carrying the aroma, right? You can saute with the butter and you shave on top. That is for the white truffle.
Never cook a white truffle.
No, absolutely not.
It's too delicate.
It's too delicate, and also you're gonna lose. You have to consider that as a very pungent aroma, but it's very delicate. So it's gonna really lose. When the black truffle, for example, is stronger, so even if you cook it, it really can help the truffle. And also you have to consider that with truffles, you want to always use a little bit of fat. because fat is carrying the aroma. Like, you know, the fat of the yolk, the fat coming from the butter, that is really a good carrier for the truffles, man.
In terms of wine, I mean, when I'm there, I love my Barolo and Barbaresco. Are there any other wines you love?
You mentioned, and you are right, this wine with a lot of tannin and very strong body, because when you eat a bite of a fatty dish, what you need, the tannin of the wine to clean your mouth and make your mouth ready for the second bite. So definitely Barolo, Barbaresco, Nebbiolo, Barbera, they have a lot of tannin, so they really clean your mouth and they really make you to enjoy the second bite, the third bite. And that is what, you know, I think the great combination in the wine. Definitely, you know, you can get an Amarone, you can get Brunello di Montalcino, but anyway, wines that have a pretty good body and a lot of tannin. We are talking here about, you know, probably around 15 pounds, okay, of truffle. Just this one is a pound, right? So, and if you can consider that right now, probably a private customer can come here and spend $6-$7 per gram. Here, we are talking about $25,000.
And worth every sniff.